Hi, it's Paul Andersen, and in this video I'm going to go over the basics of the neuron. The neuron is the basic unit in the nervous system. In a simple animal like a nematode worm, they only have 302 neurons, but what they allow them to do is to take information in from their surroundings and respond to that information. If you look at how those 302 neurons are connected, it's very complex. Now, humans are quite a bit bigger, and we have 100 billion neurons in our body. Most of those are centered in the central nervous system, in the brain, and the spinal cord, but the basic unit of our nervous system is the same. It's the neuron. If we look at the neuron anatomy and remove all the other neurons, the center is going to be what's called the cell body. This is a typical cell. It's a metabolizing cell. It's taking in energy. It's using that energy. And so it's going to have a nucleus. It's going to have Golgi apparatus, mitochondria. It's a typical cell. But there are extensions of those cell bodies called the dendrites. Those dendrites are connected to other neurons, and they're taking information in the form of neurotransmitters. In fact, this whole side of the neuron is receiving information. We then have the axon. The axon is where we're transmitting information. It begins at the axon hillock and is going to move to the terminals. Now remember that the terminals, there's a synapse that connects it to other neurons. But the signal is going to move in this direction. We're taking in information from the dendrites, the cell body, and then we can send information to the next neuron. Now, how do we do that is through an action potential, and I have a video that I'll put a link to where I go into the specifics of how that occurs. But certain axons in our body are really, really long, and for that information to travel quickly, we will wrap them in myelin sheaths. It's a Schwann cell that's wrapped around it. The way it works is we put the voltage-gated channels in between that, and it acts to insulate that nerve. It allows the information to travel more readily down that axon. And we generally say if you have an axon that's wrapped in myelin sheath, we call that a nerve fiber inside our body. Now we're taking in information as well, so there's going to be another neuron that's connected to both the cell body and the dendrites of that cell, but there's going to be a gap between these two, and we call that a synapse. It's a connection between neurons. Again, I have another video on the synapse if you want to dig into the specifics, especially of how chemical synapses work. Neurons are classified in two ways. First way is due to their structural classification. So if we take the cell body of a typical neuron, like this multipolar neuron, the way you can figure out what type of a neuron is find the cell body and figure out how many poles are coming off of that cell body. So if we count them, we have a number of different dendrites that are coming off of this neuron, and then we have one axon that's coming off, and so we call that a multipolar neuron. This is the most common neuron that we have in our body. If we look at the next one, we find the cell body again. How many poles do we have coming off of it? We've got the axon coming out and the dendrite coming in, and so we call this a bipolar neuron. Bipolar neurons are very rare. They transmit information from the receptors in our eye, receptors in our nose. If we look at the next one, here's the cell body. You can see there's only one pole coming off of that. It's actually a fused axon and dendrite, and we call that a unipolar neuron. Now, in vertebrates, it's sometimes referred to as the pseudo-unipolar neuron. These are going to be most of the sensory neurons in our body. They're taking information in and transmitting that back into the central nervous system. And then if we look at the next one, if we look at that, you can see there's no axon on it at all. And so we call that an anaxonic neuron. These are found in the brain, and they're not super understood. Now, there are a lot of other structural classifications, but these are the general ones that you're going to find in a typical anatomy class. Now, neurons can also be classified according to their functional classification. Those that take in information, stimulus, coming in from our environment, and then the response that we have. So if we kind of move that to the central nervous system, we're looking at a cross-section of the spine. So we're taking information in from receptors. So these could be in the skin, for example, touch receptors, heat receptors, pain receptors. And so we have to transmit that information to the central nervous system. So those neurons that bring information in are sometimes referred to as sensory neurons or afferent neurons. You can see this is a unipolar neuron, and it's transmitting that information into the central nervous system. And then we have information going back out. We're sending information out to effectors in our body. It could be muscles, could be glands. And we're going to call those motor neurons. They're moving away from the center. Sometimes we refer to those as efferent neurons as well. Now, there should be connections between those neurons. Those aren't all the neurons we have in our body. And so we also have these connections in the middle, and those are going to be called interneurons. And so that's the neuron. How did you do? Can you remember the different parts of the neuron? Do you remember that these are the dendrites, the cell body? Do you remember what type of a neuron this is? If not, go back and rewind it. But those are neurons, those are the basics, and I hope that was helpful.